Parliament, the institution of democracy. Why do we need a parliament? That we studied last day. Today about the two houses or the two chambers of the parliament. One is Lok Sabha and one is Rajya Sabha. These are the two chambers or houses of the parliament in India, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha is otherwise called as House of the People and Rajya Sabha is otherwise called as Council of States. Why it is called as Council of States? The MLAs from each state, they elect the MPs to the Rajya Sabha. That is why it is called as Council of States. Each and every state got a particular number of Rajya Sabha MPs according to the number of MLAs. Each state got a particular number of MPs to the Rajya Sabha. So the MLAs elect the MPs to the Rajya Sabha. In the case of Lok Sabha, the whole people of the country, whole nation, elect the MPs to the Lok Sabha. This is the main difference between Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. So the members of the Rajya Sabha indirectly elected. Second difference is that Rajya Sabha MPs are getting a time period of 6 years, but in the Lok Sabha it is only for 5 years. This is the another difference between a Lok Sabha MP and the Rajya Sabha MP. Now, Lok Sabha is called as lower house and the Rajya Sabha is called as upper house because it is indirectly elected by the people, or the MLAs are electing the MPs. So it is upper house and Lok Sabha is called as lower house. Even though it is called a lower house, Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha in some matters. First one is, any ordinary bill, if it is passed in the Lok Sabha and if it is not passed in the Rajya Sabha, then a joint session of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha decides together. The Lok Sabha MPs and the Rajya Sabha MPs sit together in a joint session and they together decide that one. So in that case, the number of Lok Sabha MPs are more and their decision will be worked out in the last. Second is, any money bill or the budget, anything, if it is passed in the Lok Sabha, the Rajya Sabha can't reject it. They can make it delay it for maximum for 14 days or they can give some suggestions, but the final decision is of Lok Sabha. So in these two cases, Lok Sabha is more powerful. One more thing, the Prime Minister is elected from the maximum number of majority of the members of the Lok Sabha MPs. That means if a non-confidential motion comes from the Lok Sabha against the Prime Minister, he and his ministry should be resigned from the post. That is very much important. So in that case also, the Lok Sabha is more important than Rajya Sabha. Prime Minister can come from the Rajya Sabha MPs. In the case of Dr. Manmohan Singh, he was the MP from Rajya Sabha. He can become the Prime Minister, but he should get the confidence of the Lok Sabha MPs. That is very much important. So in these three matters, Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha. Okay? And President is a part of the Parliament. He addresses the meeting of both the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Mainly the first meeting of the parliament, the president addresses. So he is also a part of the parliament. And for any bill to pass, any law to pass, it is the concern of the president is required. So president is also part of this system. Now we are going into executive. Who is an executive? One who execute the bill of the parliament. One who execute the order of the parliament. He is the executive. He can be political executive or he can be permanent executive. So there are two types of executive. One is political executive and another one is permanent executive. What is the difference between them? Political executive, the ministers, the prime minister and the ministers, the chief minister and the ministers, they are the part of political executive. They execute the decision of the parliament. But who signed in all this order? In the last order, Mandal order, I told you, the political executive is not signing. The permanent executive, the bureaucrat, the civil servant, he is signing over. The joint secretary signed in that bill. So, political executive, he is the one who decides everything, but the permanent executive, the civil servant, he signed all the bill. So political executive, his time period is only for 5 years, but the permanent executive, the bureaucrat, the civil servant, he continues in the post even though the government changes. That means till his retirement, the IAS officers, everyone in that post, the bureaucrats, they continue till their retirement. So they are only signing. Who is more powerful in this? Political executive is more powerful because they are, according to the will of the people, they have to rule. They are elected by the people. Permanent executive, they are not elected by the people. They come into that post because of their merits, because of their education, because of the examination which they passed. But political executives are more powerful because they are elected by the people. So they should work according to the will of the people. That is the difference, main difference between political executive and the permanent executive. Okay?